All right, guys. Well, we got a blizzard here on our hands. Check it out. We're supposed to get 12 to 20 inches. Freaking A. So, yeah. Went to work. There wasn't a flake in the air or on the ground, and then they let us out early because it's coming down like crazy. So give you an update a little later there. Well, it's the next morning and it's still dark out, but I got to snow blow the driveway to get things ready for the day. So let me show you as much as you can see what it looks like out there. From what I could tell from the news, we got about, this was at 9 o'clock last night, the last reporting is about 15 inches, but I'm sure it's more than that since, you know, after 9 till now. So, let's take a look. So, that's in front of my garage door here. I know there's a lot of drifting and stuff, but this is crazy. Look at this. I don't know. Let me put the shovel in front of it so you can get an idea. So there's my snow shovel. This is crazy. Wow. We did get a lot of snow. So, yeah, I gotta get on this. My son's gotta go to school. Well, both of them do. And, but one of them's got to get on the bus pretty soon. And I, like I said, I took off from work today to go snowmobiling. And, my wife's got to go to work a little later, so I got to clean this stuff up. All right, we're going to start the shot from here. It's quite deep out here. See how many pulls it takes to start. Let's see here. Full choke. Almost full throttle. Prime. There we go. And
All right, guys. Well, let's now that the sun came out, let's take a look and see what totally happened here. Got some snow, took care of the driveway, sidewalk, and all that stuff, and looked like it's only going to stick around for one day, even though we got like 18, 20 inches or whatever. Let's go for a little walk.
Going riding at like 1 o'clock today, going out to SOTUS. So we'll get one more ride in. I'm going to try to get some footage there too. So, you can see here, snowboat. Oh, I hear ducks, geese, something. Yeah. It's really bright out too, with all the white reflection here. The front door all cleaned up. Plows went by. Neighbor here to the right, snow blows the sidewalk so his daughter can get to my house for the bus, and then I snow blow here to my next door neighbor's, or he does it on the other side so that we can get to each other's houses if we need to, because you know we're good friends. So let's take a walk down the street here and see what kind of snow accumulated at the cul-de-sac. Got some guys out there shoveling at the end of the driveway. Try not to get run over. Apparently, when there's a state of emergency, you can ride your snowmobile on the roads. I didn't know that, or I would have been out yesterday. So, basically, you know, I say that word a lot, basically, I noticed, you know. I don't know why. I think that's just how I sum up what I'm about to say. But you can see, hey, we're not the only ones snowblowing the sidewalk here. Looks like these people do it too. Let's walk down their little path. But, yep. Got a snow blowout for the garbage too. I do that. I didn't today, but I will later. Garbage is supposed to come tomorrow. Pick up. Oh, look at these people. They go crazy. 3-4 houses down. This is awesome. It's good though, you know. Gives the kids some place to walk. That's probably why they're doing it. Kids got to get on the bus. You gotta walk to each other's houses. So, snowblow path so they don't have to walk in the street. Alright. There's a house that kind of looks like mine. But it's not. Alright, got some wind chimes going. I got the dead cat here on the camera, so shouldn't be any wind noise, hopefully. This guy is going nowhere. Doesn't even look like there's a driveway there. Now here at the end of the cul-de-sac, usually real tall snow drifts, or you know where the plows accumulated all, but it doesn't look like, I mean there's some snow there, but it's not like winter's worth because it all melted and now this is literally one snowfall's worth of snow. Yeah, when they have to do a lot of plowing, it gets tall, and you can actually, you know, sled down it. Kids can, but, you know, what you gonna do? So look at that. Snow's up to the mailboxes here. obviously plowed snow, not accumulated. But, yep, we got hit. Here's the mound here that accumulates in the cul-de-sac. We're now at the end of my street. I want to make sure the cold's not, like, shutting it off or anything. That's, I think it might be a little bit taller over here on this side because maybe some of the, you know, driveway plows are piling it up. Looks like we got this person here. Oh, they did something there. Wow. Things clean as a whistle in some spots. Anyway, I would ride a little more around the neighborhood if there wasn't one neighbor in particular that can't stand me since my trampoline blew away and smashed his house all up. That was a couple years ago. That's when I stopped really making videos of riding the Doodle Beast and the other mini bikes and dirt bikes up and down the road. Because I figure, now that I smashed his house with my trampoline, pretty much hates me. And he's going to call the cops. And I don't need that. And I also try to be a good neighbor. And I heard the guy's really just a dick. All the kids say they can't stand the fucking guy. So, I mean, yeah, kind of can understand why somebody would be mad when your trampoline blows away in a windstorm and smashes your house. But at the same time, he's a douche to everybody. So, yeah. Hope this guy either has a plow contract, snowblower, or doesn't need to go anywhere because he's not. So what else is going on? Gary's not going with us because he was out plowing all night. He does commercial plowing with a front-end loader on days that we get storms. So at 9 o'clock this morning, he was just getting home. Hadn't slept, so he's not going. And then my other buddy, Shag, wants to wait till he can get his son out of school at like 1 o'clock and he's going to go with us. So we're going to wait. We're not going to leave till 1 today. That's why, you know, we should be out riding right now. But since we're going to, that's the plan there. We're going to wait. It's pretty cold out today too. It's in the teens. And, but tomorrow it's supposed to be like, I don't know, high 30s or 40, something like that. So today will probably be the only day to ride with all this snowfall. We literally had grass showing. I mean, it was just grass on the ground a couple days ago, day before yesterday. And then literally in one day's time, all day yesterday, we got this all this snow. How are you? So, that's another little street with a cul-de-sac down there. We're not going to go down there. That's where the trampoline victim lives. Yeah. Pretty impressive. This just got pounded. Schools let out early. No, they didn't let out early. They had no school yesterday, and my work let out early at 1 o'clock yesterday. And then basically I just stayed home all night. Obviously it was a state of emergency. They don't want you on the road anyway. So here we come up to my house. Uh,
walk down the path here where I snowblowed. There's my shed. You can see it. I built that, me and my dad, when he was alive about 7 or 8 years ago. There's my neighbor, the taxi driver. And I'm going back in the garage. There's the old homestead here. You know, it's a nice little house. Not too big, not too small. I just wish I had more garage, because I got too much going on here for one car. Ugh, sled's ready. You know what's funny? Let's see. Today is Thursday. Tuesday, it was in the 50s, and I was coming home from work. There's my Harley here under the cover. And there was a guy on the road with his Harley. It was a nice day. Didn't even have gloves on. And he was riding his Harley home from work. And then literally a day later, you could be riding a snowmobile. So from one day to the next here in Rochester, New York, you could be riding road bikes, and then the next day you could be riding a snowmobile. Crazy. But let me show you the generator here real quick. So I've had this in a couple of videos. I bought a new battery for it about 3 years ago. I kind of inherited this from my dad when he passed away. So like I said, I bought a new battery for it, but since it gets seldomly used, I took that battery and put it on my riding mower that needed a new battery like last year. So this was the one on the riding mower that wasn't working too great, but I charged it up one time. It seemed to work. So now to make sure that it works and stays charged, I got my battery charger on it, and it basically works like a floater, you know, just like I got on the Harley there. I got that plugged in, you know, whenever I'm not riding it, keeps that battery fully charged. Doing the same thing now with this battery charger here. It's on like a float charge or whatever. Well, it says full because it doesn't need any. When it drops down a little voltage or whatever, boom, kicks on, gives a little juice, and then shuts back off. So that's going to be good because power goes out. I want that thing to run. It does not have a pull start. It's a 15 horsepower motor, no pull start, electric start only. It's got 7,850 watts, and it's like 10,000 max or something, but I mean it's good, really good one. 240 power and all that good stuff. I like it. I like that kind, right? All right, so here we are in the garage. I never put the Doodle Beasts or the RM60 in the crawl space for the winter. I got, you know, they've been in my way all winter, but I don't do much out here anymore in the winter other than come out here to snowblow or take the snowmobile out. So, you know, I guess if I had a lot of projects going on, then I'd need the space. I'd like to get some more projects going on. I just don't really have anything to do right now, and it's colder than hell most of the time in the winter. I don't have a heater out here. And I don't have space. So, you know, do it. You only do what you need to, right? Especially this time of year. Hopefully in the summer, with the nice weather, do some riding videos, build a few things. That'll be cool. All right, guys. Well, I'm going to end this video here. I'm going to go in and shave because I'm not quite sure I really want to grow a beard. And, you know, this is more of a vlog type of video. Not that typical for me, but hope you liked it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. And we'll see you in the next video. Take care.